This is the spider section. I went through the animals, and they do a couple different areas of the world. America, Africa, Australia, and they have the tropics inside that area. So now we'll talk about spiders, arachnids. Spiders are everywhere, but seldom known. Evolutionary fork in the road. So we have like a, what do they call these? Not a cladogram. Evolution of the orb web. New style of catching web. Mark the origin of the orb weaver's lineage. Later, some descendant lines modified the orb web into sheet webs or cobwebs. Several lines entirely lost the habit of using webs for hunting. Prey catching webs, orb webs for catching prey, modified orb webs for catching prey, loss of webs, and webless hunters. Spiders have evolved 105 families, 28 of which are shown here. To trace 380 million years of history, go clockwise. Segmented spider, folding door spider, purse web spider, funnel web tarantula. These are all tarantulas and their relatives. Funnel web tarantula, trap door spiders, tarantulas. Cellar spiders and their relatives, lampshade web spiders, crevice spiders, cellar spiders, brown recluse, spitting spiders. Gotta watch out for those brown recluse. They'll kill you. Whirligig spider. These are two clawed hunters. Whirligig, pirate spiders, giant crab spider, jumping spider, crab spider. Funnel web spider over here. Wolves, wandering spider, lynx spider, nurse web spider, wolf spider. Orb weavers, net casting spider, hackle banded orb weaver, common orb spiders, sheet web spiders, cobweb spiders, long jawed spiders, ray spiders. Spiders. Spiders are everywhere but seldom known. Spiders, scary, hairy, eek, real-life spiders may surprise you. Deep diver and desert dweller, some spiders go to extremes. This is the Namib Desert in Africa. Dancing while lady pushes her, the dancing white lady pushes her web into the sand while digging her burrow. Spiders live everywhere, cave, mountaintop, seashore, desert. Some even live in fresh water. Natural environments, converted to towns and fields, spiders less are likely to become extinct before they can be identified. Spit and suck. Spiders digest first, eat later. Unlike humans, spiders digest their food externally by repeatedly vomiting and kneading digestive juices into the prey. They then suck up the liquefied milkshake-like meal. Spider's stomach works like a bulb baster. Two sets of muscles alternately expand and contract the stomach, drawing in the juicy, pre-digested remains of the prey. That's gross. A lynx spider laps up a fly. Spider bite. Spiders don't starve if they can't catch 3 squares a day. Most spiders can fast for a month or more, not just over winter, but even during their normally active time. A larger, well-fed tarantula can go without food for as long as a year. Wow. Slurp, the Trinidad pink-toed tarantula, Avicularia, consumes a hummingbird. Arboreal tarantulas live in trees and often rob the bird's nests. Slurp, Trinidad pink-webbed tarantula. Dancing white lady, nursery web spider, fancies frog legs and the rest of the frog too. Crab spider, feasting on a fly. Spitting spider selects another spider for supper. Research a researcher milking venom from a spider. Most spiders, let's see, precise poisons, potential drugs. Venoms affect nerves in various ways. Tarantula fangs, dripping venom. Ugh. Most spider venoms contain numerous neurotoxins, substances that affect particular nerves in precise ways. Spider venoms aren't primarily intended to kill, but to mobilize prey. A paralyzed animal's preserve, the meat stays fresh until the spider is ready to eat. The chemical components of their venoms have evolved to be effective on preferred prey animals and may not be terribly toxic to other animals. Wanted for biting, Sydney funnelweb. Very large, very poisonous, very aggressive. Lunges at prey or in self-defense. Although they usually build their funnel webs outdoors, they often stake out house foundations and come into houses. Attack pose. Wanted for biting, tropical wandering spider. Aggressive and very fast, even runs up walls and glass. These spiders can be a nuisance since they live in gardens, yards, and sheds. In winter, they invade houses and move into old clothes and shoes. From South America. This one's from Australia and New Zealand. Armed and dangerous, exercise extreme caution with these four. Only a few kinds of spiders can kill a human. Bites are relatively uncommon and rarely fatal, but they can cause severe pain, illness, and tissue damage. Brown recluse, black widow. Not aggressive, the black widow, but lives in close quarters with people. Be on the lookout for widows in old wooden buildings, cellars, barns, sheds, wood piles, and outhouses under toilet seats. Brown recluse, not aggressive, generally hides during the day and hunts at night. Most bites occur between March and October because recluses hibernate. Interesting. Be on the lookout for recluses in sheds, garages, closets, attics, wood piles, cupboards, dresser drawers, behind picture frames, under furniture, in shoes and boots, just about any dry, sheltered place. Tropical wandering spider, spider funnel web. Sydney funnel spider. Last fatal attract bite occurred in 1980. So only in Australia. Victims of venom. Ooh, that butterfly got caught in the net. Tropical wandering spider. Occasionally find their way north and shipments bananas, but don't survive here. Agile, aggressive runners, even up walls glass. Sometimes a nuisance in South America. Yep, you're done for. You know how the spiders don't get stuck in their own web? They know which filaments are not sticky, because not all the filaments are sticky. And those are the ones they run along. Venom glands. In some spiders, such as tarantulas, the glands are small and contained in the jaws, but in other kinds of glands extend far back into the animal's prosoma, front body part. Muscle bands around the gland contract to squirt poison through the fangs. Fangs, the opening of the fangs. Fang is on the outside so that the pressure of fang against flesh during biting doesn't shut off the flow of venom. The fangs attach to the jaws by a movable joint. Normally the fangs fold into a groove like the blade of a pocket knife. Both sides of the groove are often lined with teeth, good for holding and mashing prey. Tarantula, big spider, small gape. Garden spider, small spider, big gape. A spider's jaws or calicra open up and down as tarantulas are sideways. As the most spiders, a sideways movement produces proportionally bigger gape, so that the smaller spiders can catch prey that is relatively large compared to their size. To kill larger prey, tarantulas must be big because their jaws don't open as wide. Let's see. In a split second, a spider unfolds its fangs, jabs in a precise dose of poison, and paralyzes its hapless prey. Elegant equipment that delivers the fateful blow consists of venom glands and a pair of hinged fangs in the spider's jaws. Attack plans, bite and wrap, or wrap and bite. Poison is always the weapon of choice in catching and keeping prey. Silk can come in handy too. When vibrations tell the garden spider, Eric Gopi, that lunch has landed on the web, the spider instantly decides how to secure the catch. If vibrations indicate that a butterfly or a moth has landed, Argiopi bites first to immobilize it because the wing scales come off easily so it could slip out of the web. Then Argiopi wraps the meal in silk and saves it to eat later. If vibrations say that it's a cricket or grasshopper that just landed, Argiopi wraps it first and inflicts the paralyzing bite later. When the hopper's strong, spiny hind legs have been tussed up in silk, Alec could injure or kill the spider, so Argiopi doesn't take chances. Wrapping a cricket. Wrapping a milkweed butterfly. Ooh, you can make your own web. I saw something where they did something. They somehow got spiders drunk or disoriented them, and they made really messed up webs. Their webs were like all fucked up. Some kind of science experiment. The orb web isn't finished. Only the frame and spokes or radii have been spun. Can you add the sticky silk spiral that will catch the prey? Study the construction. So that's what I was saying before. Spin a web. Orb weavers work. In 20 minutes, an engineering feat emerges. In a fresh web, the structural silk lines are either kinked or straight, but not curved. Only taut, radial, and frame lines transmit vibrations. Slack lines make dead zones. An orb web may have 1,200 junctions, each one made right the first time, so it's quite a feat to spin one without dead zones. As a spider spins each line, it calculates the line's tension and length in the finished web so that lines spun later don't cause earlier ones to go slack. Yeah, it's really intelligent. Super excellent silk. Spiders' silks can absorb more energy than any manufactured miracle fiber. That's because spider silks can combine great strength and toughness with some stretching in one fiber. Some man-made fibers can outperform spider silk in one capacity, but as yet not overall. Spider bite. Spider silks are protein fiber composed of 18 to 20 kinds of amino acid, and the molecular weight highly reaches 400,000. The silk protein, mainly composed of simple amino acids, takes the status of liquid crystal in the spider body. After spinning silk out of the body, the silk proteins form semi-crystal fibers in certain order. The crystallizing field enhances power mechanics and offers high flexibility to the spider silk. The ordered arrangement of the molecule chain leads to the high intensity of spider silk, and the morphology state of silk protein results in spider silk's supercontractibility in water. Spider bite, the structure of spider silk, had been always recognized similar to that of the silkworm in the past. However, according to the recent research, spider silks consist of a compound structure called sword sheath, which could better interpret some special characteristics of spider silk. Short sword sheath, huh? Surface of spider silk under SEM, section of spider silk under SEM, multi-component structure inside spider silk under TEM, surface of spider silk under atomic force microscopy. Broken spider silk shows the structure of the sword sheath. Basilica orb web. Not replaced daily, unlike most webs. Tough dense sheet shields the day hunting spider from predators and parasites and snares prey. Hack lead band orb one. This is fascinating. You can see all the different spiders. Orchard web. Egg-shaped orb. Single line of Magrapis family. This one just jerks the line around the prey. That's interesting. Sawtooth orb web. Orb web of the golden silk spider. Symphytognathid orb web. Orb web of Ogulnius. Sheet web of Dicitna. Dome web of Modissimus. Orb web of Microthena. Orb web of Anapis. Bowl and doily web of Fontanella. Tent web of Osiobius. Lampshade web of Hypochilus. Hypochilus! Normal web of Sector Spider. Too much caffeine, a regular web of Sector Spider. Is that what they did? They gave him caffeine. Curtain web of Wendell Garda. Cobweb of Nesticus. Euphoria. Filmy dome web. Netcaster. Sheet web. Open sector orb of Chrysomita. Two line web of Spintharus. Ladder orb web of Scolodaris. Bolus held by Mastophora. Dense cobweb of Tidarin family. Pitfall web of Calimaria. Funnel web spider Agelenopsis. Sheet web of Lepthifontes. Funnel web. Funnel web. Triangular orb web. Cobwebs. Asterisk web. Web of Argiope. They mentioned before the Argiope. Silks of every ilk. To every purpose, a spider suits a silk. Yeah, different thicknesses and stuff, huh? Frame lines for support. Minimal damage when an insect slams into it. Strong silk. Stretchy. Multi-purpose silk. All spiders make multi-purpose silk. Bivouacs, little sleeping bags. Sticky silk. Droplets of glue on very stretchy silk. Velcro covered threads. Stretchy silk and glue droplets, huh? Not all spiders spin sticky silk, and those that do only make one kind and not the other. Either gummy style or Velcro style. Gummy style sticky silk combines a strong, very elastic thread with droplets of glue. The thread acts like a rubber band when an insect hits, stretching and absorbing the impact on the web, and the glue traps the victim. other kind of sticky silk combines strong stretchy thread with wool, woolly thread. Spiders that make Velcro style sticky silk have a special plate called a crebellum, which spins the extremely fine woolly silk from thousands of tiny spigots. The spider uses its hind legs to comb this woolly silk into the strong stretchy threads. Velcro style silk clings to anything, even glass, but the mechanism of this incredible stickiness is mysterious. Maybe it's like gecko. The way geckos walk on glass. Egg sac silk. There's some kind of electro thing going on. Only adult females make these special thick cables, which are used only in egg sacs and whose function is still a mystery. Silk moths make silk only as larvae. And for cocoons, only one purpose. Spiders use silk throughout their lives every day for many, many purposes. Famous for their traps. Inventory of their silk products also include tablecloth, bed, crib, telegraph wire, safety nets and lines, and much more. Tablecloths, huh? Matter of life or death. At the most basic level, spiders live to make spiderlings. Spiders have been around for at least 380 million years, so it's clear that they're pretty good at it. Even so, growing up and making the next generation can be hazardous to a spider's health. Not only do spiders have to shed their skins to grow, they have to convince each other they're mates and not meals. Mother's work, a cozy egg, is all that most spiderlings can expect. Spiders lay eggs in clusters of 2 to 1,000 eggs, depending on the kind or species of spider. The eggs are held together by a gluey liquid that quickly dries and hardens. To keep the clusters together and protect them, the spider constructs a silken egg case. For most spiders, building a strong egg case is the extent of maternal care. Most spiderlings emerge from the egg cases completely on their own. Golden orb weaver spins her egg sac and lays her eggs. The spider lays her eggs on a slightly cupped base of silk. Then, if she's going to abandon the egg case, as most spiders do, she applies packing silk and ends with a solid, harder layer for protection. All of this effort pays off in protecting the eggs from bacteria, fungi, and wasp and fly parasites, and from drying out or extreme changes in temperature. Wow, interesting. They just abandon it. I guess, what's the point of sticking around, right? That's what always made it kind of like Alien. Like, you know, the Alien movies and all that. The spiders, you know, kind of vicious. Cellar spider ties her eggs together by a few threads and stays in her web, keeping the egg's mass in her fangs until the young hatch. Wow. It's kind of weird. For 3 weeks, wherever she goes, a wandering spider carries her egg sacs in a jaw. She doesn't eat, and soon after the eggs hatch, she dies. Wow. A wolf spider mother family carries her egg sac attached to the spinnerets. When it's time for the spiderlings to merge, she tears a small opening in the sack. The spiderlings hop on and get a free ride for about a week. Ugh, imagine having all those baby spiders crawl on you like that. I guess if they're your kids, it's cute, but it's kind of gross. Before her eggs hatch, a green lynx mother builds a web and low brush. Spiderlings stay in this ready-made tent for about a week until they're ready to strike out on their own. My anaconda don't want egg sac model, golden orb weaver's egg case, suspension threads, outer cocoon shell, spiderling's eggs, inner cocoon shell, packing silk. off with the old. It's the only way to grow. Spiders grow by molting, shedding their exoskeleton. When it becomes too light, too tight, the process has advantages. The spider gets a complete new set of hairs and spines and can even replace lost legs. But molting also comes with growing pains. Before its new exoskeleton hardens, the spider is defenseless. While soft, it can't even stand, much less fend off an attacker. The new shell isn't yet waterproof, so the spider may become dehydrated. Before a spider molts, a new skin grows just beneath the old one. A layer of fluid seeps between the old skin and the new. During this stage, the spider's eyes and especially its new hairs don't work well. Young orb weaver takes off its old exoskeleton, 8 legs at a time. Young orb weaver still wet behind the eyes. Weird. Spider bite tarantula brides always wear white. With each molt, females shed the lining of their reproductive organs and any leftover sperm. Some tarantula females may outlive their earliest mates by 20 years. Mexican red kneed tarantula with its molt family Therapsodia. Baby spiders look like smaller versions of adults. How often a spider molts before it becomes an adult varies by species. Female tarantulas and their relatives molt after reaching their adult stage. The mechanics of mating. For spiders, it's a three-step process. Spiders use a technique called indirect sperm transfer and mating. In contrast to all mammals, the external openings leading to the organs that produce eggs for females and sperm for males never come in contact during mating. Instead, the male transfers sperm using his pedipalps, modified legs that look like boxing gloves. Each of these pedipalps works like a syringe to inject sperm into the storage chambers in the female's abdomen. The female stores the sperm until she's ready to fertilize her eggs when she lays them, which may happen weeks later. So weird. Doesn't sound like any sexual, any fun having sex if you're a spider. Male builds a small triangular web called a sperm web and places a drop of semen into it. Then he turns around and draws the fluid up into the small tubes with the boxing glove. On his pedipalp. When both palps are filled, he's ready to look for a mate. Pulp model. Among the most complex male organs in the entire animal kingdom, consisting of membranes, light blue, hard parts, dark blue, exoskeleton, his body's external hard covering during mating, various male parts lock onto or into female parts, yellow, and as well as to each other. He puts one palp into an opening on the female's abdomen, inserts a needle-like part, inflates the membranes, and pushes sperm out, then inserts the other palp. Sounds like an examination. Palpating. Massage the fundus. That's the female part then down there, huh? Courting, mating, and making spiderlings. Male or female, boxing gloves make the difference. Generally, female spiders are bigger than males of the same species. Females bearing eggs often look fat, while males look skinnier since many don't eat much once they've reached adulthood, and their legs are usually longer. All spiders have pedipalps, leg-like appendages near the mouth, for handling prey. In females and all young spiders, the pedipalps are slender, but in adult male spiders, pedipalps look as if he's wearing boxing glove. He uses the boxing glove during mating to transfer sperm into the female. Mature female grass spider, unmodified slender pedipalps. Mature male grass spider with bulbous pedipalps, modified for mating. Spider bite, the boxing glove, pedipalps. Adult males of some species are so big in relation to the bodies that they rip off one pedipalp just to get around. Wow. Labyrinth spider. Female bottom. So this is the male tarantula, Jingzhou tarantula. And the female. Doesn't look like a female, it's got pretty big orb web spider. Male. Female. Observation corner. Relatively rich spider species, China. Recorded spiders currently in China, 56 families, 245 genera, 2,361 species, not only of various kinds, but also in large quantity. According to statistics, there are over 315 spiders per square meter in China's southern paddy field. Different geographic environments lead to different distributions of spider species. However, some kinds of spiders have a wide distribution, and we can find them in different regions. Now you may observe the following familiar spiders. So you can look at the microscope. While I look through the microscope, they show you the same thing here. Put together the puzzle parts to tell you what it is. Handy hairs. Taste, short, hollow pegs are moist inside so that molecules from the surface of the spider's touching can be carried to the nerve endings to be tasted. Smell, tiny ring pits, modified hair sockets are important in recognizing prey and enemies, not to mention potential mates, and may also detect humidity. Hearing, long hairs are extremely sensitive to air movement and able to detect even the faintest breeze from an insect's movement. Touch, regular hairs are touch sensitive. So there's all different kinds of hairs. Sensitive slits can sense place in space. Small slits all over the body, but especially near the 83 joints, send signals to the spider's nervous system about the body's orientation, help the spider find its way back to retracing steps. Back by retracing steps. All the different types of hair. Eye to eye. Jumping spiders are the exceptions to the rule. They can see well. Two of their eight eyes, which resemble headlights, have a small field of vision and can focus clearly. Jumping spiders are so dependent on sight that without light, they can't catch food or even recognize mates. Jumping spiders see better than other spiders. Their huge front eyes register sharp color images. Family Salticidia. Crab spider. Spitting spider. Crevice spider. Wolf spiders rely on two large eyes above and four below. Last pair keeps a lookout to the rear. Nursery spider. Wow. Net casting spiders have two rear eyes so large that the other six are hard to find. What spiders see? 80 eyes do not equal 20/20 vision. 8 eyes. Anterior and posterior, lateral and median eyes, huh? Only the two main eyes detect color and sharp images. The other six function like our peripheral vision. I guess you'd have to have a pretty big brain to process all the visual stuff going on. You have eyes in the back of your head, but your vision's blurry and you see distorted images. If you're a spider. Spider eyes. How animals live in the natural world is based on characteristics that they have evolved. As a human, you're a very visual, vocal animal with a good brain, but a bad nose and mediocre ears. Now pretend you're a spider. Spider eyes. You have eight legs, eight generally not so good eyes, and a hard skeleton all over the outside of your body. Spiders, let's see, and their skin, relation to and difference between spiders and other groups. Dust mite, tick, scorpion, daddy long legs. Spiders are related to insects, but it's easy to tell them apart. A spider has two main body parts and eight legs. An insect has three main body parts and only six legs. Instead of backbones, both spiders and insects have exoskeletons, and both have segmented bodies with jointed legs and appendages, putting them in a group of animals called arthropods, whose name means jointed feet. The spider's closest arthropod cousins are arachnids, or other arachnids. Other arachnids include scorpion, ticks, and mites, and daddy long legs. Only spiders have abdominal spinnerets, organs for spinning silk. Wood scorpion, Malaysian giant scorpion, Arizona longtail scorpion, Arizona bark scorpion, whiptail scorpion, Calaveras wood scorpion. Classy arachnids. Spiders may steal the spotlight, but the class Arachnida includes some other extraordinary creatures. All arachnids have four pairs of legs, eight in all. They have pedipalps, front appendages used for feeding and hunting. Count the legs on these scorpions, but don't be fooled by the big claw-shaped pedipalps. Those are mouth parts. Rawr. Arr, arr, arr.
Aha! I see you! Ah! It's an earthquake! It's an earthquake!
I shouldn't do that. That's really immature. So really immature. Don't do it. Don't. Oh, he's got crickets. He's got crickets. I had a couple friends who had tarantulas growing up. They should have one, and they should have a spider jump out at you like the can of peanut brittle that the snake pops out of. Freak people out. Your skin's hard. You can't rely on pressure-sensitive touch to feel what's around you. Small slits in your exoskeleton and hairs that poke through it keep you in touch with your surroundings. Receptors of the spider uses the outside world, smell, taste, sound, temperature, gravity, distributed all over the body, except for the eyes. So that's what the hair does, huh? Touch the spider to begin. Put your hands on the string to feel the vibrations. The numbers at the ends of the strings match the buttons on the right. So am I supposed to do this and say where it's coming from, where my prey came from? I don't feel anything. Oh, you gotta use both hands. Woo! This one, 7. It's a B, huh? Humans can hear some spider sounds. Some tarantulas earn their scientific name, Psalmopoeus, psalm singer, by hissing. They're not vocalizing, but stridulating, rubbing stiff bristles against a file on their bodies to scare off enemies or collectors. Touch the string below to get a feel for each of the prey. Fly, moth. So it communicates with the world around through vibrations. Wow. That's interesting. Tallulah Tarantula Tells All. With a body of about 10 centimeters, 4 inches long, and 25 centimeters, 10 inches leg span, females of this species of Theraphosa blondii, weighing at 135 grams, are the largest spiders. They live in tropical rainforests of Latin America and sometimes prey on frog, lizard, and small mammals. I think they call it the bird-eating spider, don't they? For most spiders, small, smart, small animals set up housekeeping in quarters so cramped that a human couldn't even squeeze a toe in them. The small spiders live in leaf litter. As adults, they're less than a millimeter long, even counting their legs. Spider speak, spider speck. Ceratocellus adult male. That's the head of a pencil. Ooh. Very small. Spider life is cheap. Many spiderlings start life, but few survive. A spider may lay scores or even thousands of eggs, but few will live to adulthood. Spiders, spiderlings, or spider eggs are on the menu for ants, wasps, beetles, flies, bugs, dragonflies, crickets, harvestmen, scorpions, mites, birds, frogs, lizards, snakes, fish, and even fungi, humans, and other spiders. Praying mantis is eating one. Birds, spider eating another spider. Hummingbird in South America feeds spiders to their young. A living paralyzed spider in a mud dauber wasp net. Spider infected by fungi died in mid-sleep high on a tree trunk in Madagascar. Defensive living. Spiders would rather dodge than fight. Defenses. First line of defense is to stay out of harm's way. Biting is always the last resort. When threatened, spiders simply drop to the ground and play dead or head for the nearest hideout. Other strategies for escaping include blending in, disguising, mimesis, and self-amputation. Mimesis. What's mimesis? Looking like something else? Poisonous. Looking poisonous, maybe? Is it a ladybug or an orb weaver? This orb weaver looks like lichen. This bolus spider is disguised as bird droppings. I guess that one there, huh? Six-eyed crab spider buried in the sand. Whirligig spider on bark blending in. Wow, that's cool. Crab spider on a sunflower. Net casting spider on a twig. Where? Can barely see it. Wow, here, I guess. Crab spider on a rose. Giant crab spider on leaf. Hairy counterattacks. Tarantulas send attackers packing by brushing off their own barbed hairs. The spider uses its hind legs to aim a cloud of venomous barbs at the nose, lips, and eyelids of predatory mammals. Articulating hairs. Articulating means itchy. Cause itchiness. We're back at the beginning. That's it. That's the whole exhibit. Cool. See how much time I have left before closing. Probably not much.